Okay, now I want to do a few sample problems from section 1.1 of the textbook. So first, let's look at number 14. So in the problem, they're giving you a system of equations and asking you to solve it. So I've already got it here in the augmented matrix form. And so we just need to do elementary row operations in order to try to solve the system. So the first thing we want to do is make sure that up here in the 1-1 position, that's the first row, first column, we've got a non-zero value if possible. Well, it's already non-zero, so we don't need to do anything. If this had been a zero, we would want to swap rows in order to get a non-zero value here. Okay, but we already have one, so then we can next turn our attention to creating zeros in the column below this leading entry. Okay, a leading entry is the first non-zero value in a row, so we want to create zeros below it. So we need to create a zero in this position here. So we need to figure out what do we multiply by this one and add to negative one to get zero. And clearly, to multiply by one or don't multiply by anything, just need to add the first row to the second, and that will give us a zero here. So so I'm going to add row 1 to row 2. Now that does not change row 1, so I'm just going to repeat it here. And it doesn't change row 3. Okay, so now row 2, we got our 0 there. Then we'll have negative 3 plus 1 gives us negative 2. 0 plus 5 is 5. And 5 plus 2 gives us 7 here. All right. So now we've got our leading entry, zeros below it. We're done with that column, so we move on to the next column and down a row. So we want a non-zero element here, which we already have. And normally we would just want to zero out below it, but given that we have a 1 here, that's kind of a nicer number to work with, so I'm going to actually swap rows 2 and 3 at this point. Swap row 2 and row 3. And so row 1 doesn't change. New row 2 is the old row 3. And the new row 3 is the old row 2. Alright, so I got that. Now, the reason I did that was because this just makes the arithmetic easier, and I don't have to deal with fractions. Otherwise, if I left the negative 2 there, I'd have to figure out, you know, what do I multiply by this to add to 1 to get 0? And I would have to carry that out through the rest of that row. So this is just easier arithmetic-wise. So now I've got a 1 here, and I need to zero out underneath it. So I need to multiply by 2 and add to negative 2 to get a 0 here. So my next operation is 2 times row 2 added to row 3. Okay, so row 1 again doesn't change. Row 2 doesn't change. And row 3, let's get my 0 there, and I'll get 2. Look over here, 2 times 1 plus 5 is 7. Then we've got 2 times 0 plus 7 is 7. Okay, now at this point, I'm done with the second column, and I move over, and I'm done with the matrix, because now in the third row, I've eliminated all the variables except for 1. So from the third row, I get 7x3 equals 7. So I can solve for x3, it's going to be 1. And then I do the back substitution. All right, so that means back up. So I back up to the second row, which looks like if I write down the equation corresponding to the second row, be x2 plus x3 equals 0. But I know what x3 is, so I plug that in. And I've got x2 equals negative 1. Okay, then I back up again to the first row. The first row, that equation looks like x1 minus 3x2 equals 5. I know what x2 is. Plug that in. So a little more room here. And so I get x1 is equal to, let's see, that's a plus 3. So we're going over minus 3, so it would be 2. So x1 equals 2. X2 equals negative 1. X3 equals 1. There's a solution to my system. Okay, so this system here had a unique solution. Just one. All right. Let's go on and look at another homework problem. This time I want to go to number 12. Okay, so still in section 1.1, problem number 12. Actually, before we do that, let's look at one thing. Before we do that, let's look at one other thing. Suppose I have a system that looks like this. 2x1 plus 3x2 equals 10. And how about 4x1 plus 6x2 equals 12? Now, if you examine that a little bit, you're going to see that to get this second equation, I just multiply the first one by 2, right? So 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6. But then I didn't multiply this by 2. Or actually, I did, and then I didn't want to get that same value, so I changed it. So just based on that analysis, it seems that this system should have no solution, right? And if you were solving it using elimination, say, right, maybe you'd multiply, maybe you didn't notice that it's not going to have a solution, so you're just merely going along your way solving it. So if we multiply 3 by negative 2, we're going to get negative 4x1 minus 6x2 equals negative 2 times 10 is negative 20. Then we'd add that, and here we get 0. Here we get 0. So on the left, we've got 0. And on the right, what do we have? Negative 8. Well, 0 can't equal negative 8, right? So this is what tells us that this system has no solution. Okay, we get to this point where we have 0 on the left and something not 0 on the right. Okay, got a non-zero value over here on the right. Okay, so if we had thrown that into a matrix, it would look like this. All right, so we do one row operation, same one we did up there, negative 2, row 1 plus row 2. All right, so row 1 doesn't change. In row 2, get negative 2 times 2 is negative 4, plus 4 gives us 0. Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6, plus 6 gives me 0. Negative 2 times 10 is negative 20, plus 12 is negative 8. Alright, so if you look at this, we're the same thing, right? We've got all zeros. And over here on the right, we've got something that's not zero, okay? This is the marker that you look for to indicate no solution, okay? All zeros on the left, something not zero on the right, okay? So keep that in mind. We're going to be using that all semester. Okay, so now let's go to number 12. OK, Okay, still in section 1.1. So number 12, 1, negative 3, 4, negative 4. Negative 7, 7, negative 8, negative 4, 6, negative 1, and 7. Okay, and this is an augmented matrix. So we start, we do our row operations. So we look, we've got a non-zero value here, so we want to zero out underneath. So the first thing I'm going to do is negative 3 times row 1 plus row 2, so that I can generate a 0 there. So I got 1, negative 3, 4, negative 4. All right, first row and the third row don't change. And this one, I can get my 0 there. Then what do I got? Negative 3 times negative 3 is 9, minus 7 gives me 2 there. Negative 3 times 4 is negative 12, plus 7 is negative 5. Negative 3 times negative 4 is 12, minus 8 is 4. Okay, so I got my 0 there. I need to keep working down, get a 0 in this position. So the next operation I'm going to do will be 4 times row 1 plus row 3. So again, row 1 doesn't change. Row 2 doesn't change. And row 3, I get my 0 there. So I'm at 4. Minus 4 gives me 0. 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. Plus 6 is negative 6. 4 times 4 is 16. Minus 1 is 15. 4 times negative 4 is negative 16, plus 7 is negative 9. All right, so that first column is looking good. Then I move over to second column, second row. I've got a non-zero value here, so I want to zero out underneath. So I need to work on that 6 there. Okay, so I'm going to multiply row 2 by 3. And add that to row 3, because 3 times 2 is 6. Minus 6 gives me the 0 that I need right here. So 1, negative 3, 4, negative 4. Row 2 doesn't change. And row 3, I get my it's already 0. So 3 times 0 plus 0, 0. 3 times 2 is 6. Minus 6, there's my new 0. 3 times negative 5 is negative 15, plus 15 is 0. Okay, and remember we're looking, at this point you can see we got all zeros here. Okay, and then we're ready to get the last position, and what do we have here? We want, 3 times 4 is 12, minus 9 gives us 3. So what do we have here? We've got all zeros on the left, and on the right we've got a value that's not zero. So as we saw before, that means this system has no solution. Okay, all right, I want to do one more problem from this section. This one is let's see. Actually, maybe a couple more. Let's look at number, number 22. Okay, 22. 22 looks like this. Okay, we put it in the matrix form. Okay, now the directions ask you to find the values of H, okay, this parameter, for which this system is consistent. Okay, so to do that, you want to just get an echelon form. Or actually, we don't know what echelon form is yet. Let's just do what we've been doing. So, we've got our non-zero value here. We zero out underneath it, so multiply by 3. So I'm going to do 3 times row 1 plus row 2. So that gives me a 0 there. Oops, this doesn't change. Okay, so 3 times 2 is 6. Minus 6 gives me 0 here. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. Plus 9 gives me 0 here. And 3 times h plus 5 is just 3 times h plus 5. All right. Now at this point, look, it looks just like the one previous, right? Look back at the one we were just looking at. We had all zeros and then something not zero. Well, here we have all zeros, okay? So that's significant. But over here, we don't know what this is because we're asked to find h so that this system is consistent. So we want this to, we want 3h plus 5 must equal 0 for the system to be consistent. Okay, so that means that 3h must equal negative 5. So h has to equal negative 5/3. Okay, so that's what we're looking for this one. Right, because this has to equal 0 for the system to be consistent. Right, because if this is not 0, we're like this case up here where there's no solution. All right, let's look at one more. And I'm kind of going out of order here just because I like kind of stick with the same theme. So I'm going to back up to number 20. And it's a similar kind of question as 22. But this time the h is not on the right side. It's part of the coefficient matrix. So it's a little bit different. So again, we do our row operations. We got a non-zero here. We want to zero out this position. So we do 2 times row 1 plus row 2. So I've got 1h, negative 3. And I got a 0 here. 2 times h plus 4, and 2 times negative 3 is negative 6, plus 6 is 0. All right, so I've got this situation. Now remember, the problem is to find h such that the system is consistent. Well, system is consistent as long as we don't have a case like we had up here. Right, system is consistent as long as we don't have a row that looks like 0, 0, and then something not 0. Okay? Well, notice that that can never happen. We can never have 0, 0, something not 0, because the right-hand side is already 0. Okay? So that means this system, myself a little more room here. This system is always consistent, right? Because we can never have a row of the form 0, 0, and then on the augmented side, something not 0. Right? Can't happen in this case because the right-hand side is a 0. Okay, so this system is always consistent, irregardless of what h is. All right, so I think that's about it for section 1.1. As always, keep in mind that you can call me up, email me anytime to let me know if you have any questions. All right, good luck with those homework problems.